Hi Paula, I see that Trish has sent you an email about getting your PAT maths on, so I thought I'll send you a video link up to show you how to do that. So what you're going to do is go into nzcermarking.org.nz, so the web address just up the top here, and you'll need to put your teacher, your password in, which I believe is P Redmond, and then teacher 13, and then just click login. Now you're going to need your tests with you, obviously, to do this. So then what you're going to do is zip into PAT Mathematics. And you'll see there that there's actually a space for you already done, room 13 down the bottom here. So what you're going to do is click Data Entry. Now I'm going to show you one of mine to show you how it's done. It's really, really simple. What you're going to do is just click on the first one. And then if I just go C, D, A, it'll just keep automatically tabbing across, okay? So once you've done a student, you go all the way through the bottom and you click save. And then what you can do is go up and select your other students. It's a pretty quick job to do. So that's your first step there. So once you've done that, what you can actually do is go and see reports on your class. So yours, again, you'll go to room 13, but you can get information about their results in a list of scaled scores and stay 9 scores and so on. You can get stay 9 lists in different fashions. So how many students are at each stay 9. You can get individual item stuff. So how many kids got this one correct, like 15 students, and my percentage correct was 80% got them right. Mine got 80% right, and the national average is 70, so my kids are pretty good at that. This one here, the national average, my kids weren't great at what change unknown things are. So this is really cool because it tells you about what sort of gaps you might have. So national average should be the red, but if they're not quite there, that's an area you can teach them in. And you can also get individual student reports, which is pretty cool because it shows you which questions they got wrong and which ones they got right. So anything below the red line, they absolutely should have gotten right. That's within their ability to do it. Anything that's above the red line, if it's an incorrect answer, like it's a blank number there, it's unlikely that this person would get question number 12 correct, given their ability and the rest of the test. So it's quite cool what it does there. So that again tells you what the learning objective is, and we can go and find out what number strategies they know, and this helps us because we can then see what gaps there are again and what we need to teach them. So that's just very, very quickly what you need to do, and I hope this has been helpful. Catch you later.